स्टूडेंट, आई एम रूपाली हियर टू टीच यू क्लास 10 साइंस सब्जेक्ट. फ्रॉम साइंस देर आर थ्री पार्ट्स अगेन, केमिस्ट्री, फिजिक्स एंड बायो. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द लेसन फ्रॉम केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज एसिड, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. प्रीवियसली यू हैव नॉलेज अबाउट वॉट आर द एसिड्स, वॉट आर बेसिस एंड वॉट आर द सॉल्ट्स. कॉमन एग्जाम्पल्स विच यू हैव सीन प्रीवियसली of acids that are sulfuric acid. This is its molecular formula H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Another common example is hydrochloric acid, that is HCl. Third example, common known for you is nitric acid HNO3 and carbonic acid H2CO3. These all four examples are of mineral acid, which are seen naturally. And another mineral acid means these all are inorganic acids, and organic acid which you are knowing is acetic acid. Acetic acid means which is getting from vinegar which contain acetic acid in 8 to 10%. Another organic acids are benzoic acid, phthalic acid, etc. Some common examples of bases are caustic soda, that is sodium hydroxide, caustic potash, potassium hydroxide, its formula is KOH, ammonium hydroxide, formula is NH4OH, and calcium hydroxide. It is also called as lime water. Means generally, the examples of bases which contain OH group, that is hydroxyl group, OH. It also contain OH, this example also contain OH, and lime water also contain OH. Means generally bases contain hydroxyl group. Salts, some example of salts which are common salt. Common salt means sodium chloride which you are using in your daily means meal. Barium chloride BaCl2, potassium chloride KCl, potassium sulfate K2SO4, sodium nitrate NaNO3, ammonium chloride NH4Cl. It don't mean that all these salts will contain chlorine. It is not like that. But when acid and bases come together, they form salt and water. This salt is the combination of acid and base. With that, it forms the one byproduct as a water. So there are so many examples in our environment. Of the salt, these are magnesium chloride, barium sulfate, lead sulfate, ammonium chloride, etc. There are many examples of bases also and acids also, but I have given common examples to you. So actually, what is acid, what is base, or what is salt? Previously we have seen all about it, but again we will revise it as an introductory part. Acid, it is sour in taste. Then base, it is bitter in taste. And how we can identify the nature of the all the salts, bases and acids? There are some indicators in the laboratory. Indicators means when we add those liquids or these substances in acid, bases, then they give some specific color to it. These substances, chemical substances, are called as the indicator. So, which are those indicators which are used for the identification of acid bases? These are phenolphthalein, methyl orange, red litmus and blue litmus. Litmus, it is in paper form also, that is litmus paper, red litmus paper or blue litmus paper, or these are in the liquid state also. These acids means main general property of acid is it is sour in taste. General property of base is in bitter taste. Then these acids, these are harmful to us. They, when we touch the acid, then they may irritate our skin or the skin may burn. Then bases, these are soapy in touch. So these are common tests for the identification of acid and bases. Another chemical test for identification or differentiation of the acid and base is litmus test. When any substance means from this सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड, देन हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, नाइट्रिक एसिड, कार्बोनिक एसिड, एसिटिक एसिड और बेंजोइक एसिड इफ इट इज टेकन इन द टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड इफ विल एड ब्लू लिटमस पेपर इन टू इट देन इट चेंजेस इट्स कलर मीन्स ब्लू लिटमस इट चेंजेस इन टू रेड कलर बट इफ वी डीप रेड लिटमस इन टू द एसिड देन इट डू नॉट शो द चेंज इन कलर इट रिमेन्स एज इज इट बट अपोजिट ऑफ दिस इज फॉर द बेसिस When any basic substance is taken in the test tube and if we dip the red litmus into basic substances, then it turns into the blue color. But there is no change in the blue color of the blue color of this litmus paper into red. It remains as it is. Means one differentiation that we have seen now chemically that is when red litmus paper deep into the acidic substances or liquids then it changes blue litmus changes into red color and for the bases when blue litmus is deep into these basic substances then it changes into the red within this way there is differentiation of these substances chemically but there are many different indicators we will see in the chart form how they changes actually by our activity another now these acids means H2SO4 HCl HNO3 H2CO3 these all are mineral acid and they are in concentrated form we can dilute it but they are means they are burning our skin easily so we should not directly touch to these acidic substances If there are bases, we can touch them, but they are soapy in nature. And salts, these are the combination of acid and bases. So we are saying this reaction as a neutralization. For example, how this NaCl is formed by this neutralization reaction. It is a chemical reaction. Suppose we will take NaOH. That is sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid that is HCl when they react with each other they form NaCl that is sodium chloride and water so you must know the chemical reaction different types of the chemical reaction chemical formula of all substances while writing the chemical reaction so once again you have to revise the molecular formula of each and every substance so here we will see H2SO4 that is sulfuric acid HCl hydrochloric acid HNO3 nitric acid H2CO3 carbonic acid and acetic acid formula is CH3COOH Now I have given here some examples of acid, bases and salt. Now one by one we will take the reactions of acidic substances first. So now we will see those reactions. This how acids react with metal, how they react with bases. So we will see some examples of those substances how they react. First thing. How acids react with metals? React with metals. You are knowing examples of the metals. Common examples of metals are suppose copper, that is denoted by Cu. Then iron, denoted by Fe symbol. Zinc. It is denoted by Zn. Aluminium. It is denoted by Al. Magnesium. It is denoted by symbol Mg. These are some common examples of the metals. Now, how they react? In those metals, again there are some noble metals and some are basic metals. So which are base metals? Base metals means metal which react easily with the chemical substances. And the metals which do not show the reaction easily, with another chemicals, those are called as noble metals. So now, which are noble metals? Copper. We are using it for making the utensils. Then ornaments are made from the gold and silver. These are also noble metals. They do not show easily reaction with the other chemicals. So we will take the examples of some base metals, that is zinc, iron, magnesium, aluminium, how they show reaction with the acids. Suppose we have taken sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid, and to this sulfuric acid, if we add iron filings, these iron filings, how they react? First, we will take sulfuric acid formula, that is H2SO4. Iron filings means Fe, and they react with each other to give FeSO4 iron sulfate and here H2SO4 plus Fe. In this Fe react with sulfate group from the sulfuric acid, and it changes into FeSO4, that is iron sulfate. And this hydrogen gas get evolved or released in the atmosphere. This how metals react with the acid. We can take another acid also. Suppose HCl I have taken, and same iron filings I have taken. And how do they show the reaction? Due to presence of this Cl from HCl, it changes into FeCl3. Iron chloride plus of again hydrogen gas get released. But here we need to balance the chemical reaction. Last year in 9th standard we have seen how we have to balance the chemical reaction. In the chemical reaction, the part which is present at the right side, that is called as the product, and the part which is present at the left side, these are the reactants. These reactants may be one, two or many, and product also one, two or many. So this is the transformation, means reactant transform or changes into product. So in this common, what we have seen, when iron react with the sulfuric acid or iron react with the hydrochloric acid, it evolves H2 gas. In the same way, if we will change this metal in place of iron, if we will take the zinc, then same they will show the change by evolution of the hydrogen gas. It means that when zinc is taken, zinc powder, when it is added to the hydrochloric acid, then it will change into ZnCl2 plus of H2. Which here again common thing from those all reaction is that when any metal react with mineral acid. Mineral acid means it may be sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid or carbonic acid. They react with the mineral acid to give the corresponding salt by evolution of the hydrogen gas. This is the first chemical property of these metals or acids, that is acid reacts with the metal to give the corresponding salt by release of hydrogen gas in the atmosphere. These are about the chemical reaction of the acid with the metal. Another thing, now when bases are taken for the react to see the reaction between bases and metal, the same change can be seen. They also form the salt by evolution of the hydrogen gas, but some of the metal they form only salt without evolution of the hydrogen gas also. So that we will see by the activity. Now student, we are going to start about activity. First thing, we have seen that how acid and bases show the changes by the litmus paper. This is ammonia. When ammonia is added into the water, it changes into ammonium hydroxide. So we have given the example of base, that is ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH. Now this is blue litmus paper. Blue litmus paper. So we will see the change of the color of this litmus paper. Now tell me, is there any change in this blue litmus paper? No. It has remained as is it. means blue litmus paper remain blue as is it when we dip into the basic solution. Now I have taken red litmus paper. So this is red litmus paper. I have dipped this glass rod in ammonia solution. So we can see the nature of ammonia. Now this red litmus paper shows the change into the blue. See this change when we have taken red litmus paper. This is red litmus. When we have taken this ammonia in contact with this red litmus, it completely changes into blue. From this generally we can say that basic solutions are showing the change as red litmus changes into the blue and blue litmus remain as is it. Now another example we will see. I have taken this solution as dilute H2SO4. So this dilute H2SO4, if I will take in one test tube, here I am taking dilute H2SO4. We should not directly touch to this H2SO4, it is acid. When we come in contact with this H2SO4 directly, then it burns our skin. Now this is red litmus solution. I have taken it in the test tube. Actually you can see here, these are the indicators. This is litmus solution red, another litmus solution blue, and this one is methyl orange. These all are acid based indicators, means they show the change in color when we add these solutions into this acid and bases. This red litmus solution I have taken in the test tube. This is H2SO4. We will see. Is it showing any color change? No. Means here red litmus solution remain as is it in the acidic solution. But if we will take again this H2SO4 solution in the test tube, this is H2SO4. If I will take this blue litmus solution and I will add to this H2SO4, then you can see easily change of this H2SO4 solution into the red. It means that blue litmus changes into red in acidic medium and red litmus remain as is it in acidic medium. Now another, this I am taken, that is methyl orange. This is the indicator, acid base indicator, methyl orange. That also remain as is it, that is orange in color when we add acidic medium or acidic solution. Here we are providing acidic medium, but methyl orange remain as is it. In this way, there are some activity or some tests to identify if two different solutions are given, that is if one is acidic and another is basic, then by outer means its appearance we cannot identify it is basic or acidic solution. But when we are trying to dip this red litmus or blue litmus paper into it or methyl orange indicator, then by their change in color we can easily identify is it basic solution or acidic solution. In this way you can see the different test. Suppose this is potassium hydroxide. If I have taken, now see, this is the test tube. This I have taken potassium hydroxide solution and this is blue litmus solution. So in potassium hydroxide, blue litmus remain as is it. So you might be identify that there are color changes due to acidic medium and providing the basic medium. Means three part you have seen. First thing is that acid is sovereign test. Second thing, we cannot directly touch to the acidic medium or acidic solution because it burn our skin. And if red litmus is taken or dipped into the acidic medium or acidic solution, it remains as is it, and if blue litmus is added into it, it turns into red. These are the common tests for the acidic solution. Now, we have seen one chemical reaction, that is about iron filings and zinc. Now, these are the iron filings. So, these iron filings, we will check now reaction between this H2SO4 and iron filings. I have taken again one test tube. In that, I have added some iron filings. Now, here it is H2SO4 solution, but it is dilute. If we will take concentrated H2SO4, it will show the fast reaction. Concentrated means there is more percentage of H2SO4 and less percentage of water. But diluted solution means the solvent H2SO4 is in less amount and water quantity is more. Slowly we have to add this H2SO4. It will take little time. If you will see from nearby, slowly it react with this iron filings, and you can see the bubbles which comes from the bottom of this test tube. Here bubbles are seen. These bubbles are nothing but the hydrogen gas which get evolved during the chemical reaction between H2SO4 and iron filings. We have seen the chemical reaction, that is H2SO4 plus iron, that is Fe. It changes into FeSO4 and H2 gas. So bubbles are nothing but the hydrogen gas, and it shows the slow reaction. In the same way, we can see the reaction between zinc metal and H2SO4 also. Now this is the zinc dust. We can take the zinc dust with the spatula. Little amount of zinc dust I have taken in the test tube, and now I am going to add this H2SO4 slowly into the test tube containing zinc powder. Now you can see the chemical reaction in the test tube. That is, first zinc dust I have taken, slowly I have added H2SO4, and you can see the bubbles. The fast effervescence comes out during this chemical reaction. It means that zinc react with H2SO4 fast, but these iron filings react with H2SO4, but this reaction is slow. So slow effervescence comes out, and these effervescence or bubbles are of hydrogen gas. So first chemical reaction we have seen, how do metals react with acid. This is all about this chemical reaction between metal and acids, as well as the identification of acid and bases. Students, now we are seeing another activity about bases. Means how do bases react with metal. In the first activity, we have seen that when metals react with the acid, they evolve hydrogen gas by formation of the corresponding salt. In the same way, when bases react with metals, they also form corresponding salt by evolution of the hydrogen gas. So hydrogen gas is seen in the test tube in the form of effervescence or bubbles. Now this is sodium hydroxide. These are in the form of the pellets. If you will see, pellets mean these are the crystals of sodium hydroxide. So these I have made a solution of sodium hydroxide by adding some of the pellets into water. In this way we got sodium hydroxide solution. This is the base. Potassium hydroxide, it is also base. Ammonium hydroxide, it is also base. So any basic solution we can take in the test tube. And another thing, we have to see the reaction between these metals. Now here two metals are present, that is, one is the iron filings and another is the zinc powder. We will see the reaction between iron filings and this sodium hydroxide basic solution. So I have taken some of the iron filings in the test tube. In another test tube, there is presence of sodium hydroxide solution. This sodium hydroxide solution I am adding in the test tube containing ion filings. We have to see the reaction between these ion filings and sodium hydroxide. Here also same thing is seen. When it react with this sodium hydroxide, this is slow reaction. So slowly from this bottom of the test tube, you can see the release of hydrogen gas in the form of the bubbles. Slowly it react with sodium hydroxide. Another, now I will take in another test tube zinc metal, which is in the form of dust. Now this zinc metal I have taken in the test tube, and again I am adding the sodium hydroxide solution into the test tube containing zinc metal. Here you can find that hydrogen gas comes in the form of bubbles from the bottom of this test tube. So when any metal react with the basic solution, then it forms its corresponding salt and hydrogen gas get released. So when this NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide, react with the zinc metal, it form the Na2ZnO2. Na2, that is sodium zincate. So in this way, acid as well as bases react with metal to give the corresponding salt and hydrogen gas come